A man swings a bucket of water at a constant speed in a vertical circle. How can the water stay in the bucket? Let's consider the water when the bucket is at the topmost position. At this instant, the water has a horizontal velocity. The Earth's gravitational pull would have caused the water to continue along a parabolic arc. The bucket, however, intends to follow a circular path. Relative to the circular path of the bucket, the parabolic path would have taken the water through the top, thus puncturing the base of the bucket. The bucket, of course, would not want to be punctured. So what it does is to exert downward normal contact force on the water, just enough to push the water into following the same circular path as the bucket. The water falls out of the bucket only if it drops faster than the bucket. As long as the bucket is swung at a high enough speed, this will not happen. This is because at a high enough speed, the centripetal acceleration v squared over r is larger than the acceleration of free fall g. The bucket achieves this larger than g acceleration with the help of the man's pull. The water achieves this larger than g acceleration with the help of the bucket's push. If the bucket is swung at too low a speed, then the acceleration of free fall g is larger than the centripetal acceleration v squared over r. The bucket achieves this smaller than g acceleration with the help of the man's push. The water gets no help from the bucket to fall at a rate slower than g. That's when the man gets wet.